and I am almost never on a stool. I don't like my patient towering over me. I like to have their center of mass close to my center of mass. So my approach to control the knee, because the knee can be buckling or hyperextending, and I don't want either one, is to bend over a bit, put my hand on the pelvis, tuck them to my shoulder so I can help with the weight shift. But I'm going to use my hand at their knee, and my thumb is behind the knee to help unlock if they're hyperextended, and I can use my fingers to pull them back into extension if they're buckling. Now, this looks like it's really hard on your back, but I end up leaning my elbow on my knee and being into more of a squat. So I'm not really bent over. I'm squatting down, bracing myself here to hold my upper body. And now I'm going to weight shift her off of her like she's going to step with. I can give her a cue, right foot. Then she weight shifts forward and left. I can help advance the leg if need be. Now I need her to come. Weight shift over, step through. Gain, left, right, come on over. Good. So at this stage, now that I'm down here, I can help advance. I'm not jumping around a lot. I can, again, give feedback, say, feel your knee, you know, keep it locked, keep it locked. As I bring her hips forward over her leg, I can make sure the knee doesn't buckle. And now we're ready to take a step. And I can do as little or as much as I need to. Good. Good. It's really not hard. This is not hard on my back. It's not, you know, a lot of work because I'm leaning on my own leg.